New business. The revised train operating budget.
Yeah, since we've had such a major change in revenue and trying to reduce expenditures, we're trying to do some revisions here.
Yeah, I mean,
here on the rest of the fiscal year.
Leo, I think, gave you the budget of 9.5, which reflects what Marvin, him and I did. I've got the detailed one, whether you have the detail or the summary.
This is summary.
Summary.
Yeah, okay. So, I mean, we made the cuts for the off-season, some marketing items, which the previous marketing director committed to, which we didn't feel necessary. So there are a number of categories we chopped. I guess what I want to stress is, you know, if you guys would approve this, but certainly it's going to be a work in progress. And with the uptick we're seeing in the fall colors and the ridership and the higher $7 to $8 per passenger revenues going up, I think the next time we undertake this in a few weeks, it'll be a little more positive and show that we can stretch the cash out a little further. So it is a work in progress. Leo, go ahead. Anything else you want to say about that?
Mostly, I think we want to reflect a revised budget, particularly as we go to the legislatures and discuss our need for funding with them. Coming with the revision to try to reflect as much as we can the impact of fire and what it's done to operating revenue, how much it's down. And as Randy talked about, the reductions that we can see and accomplish in expenditures, but the fact that we're still in the red and we need to find a way to replace those funds, because a lot of that's our operating capital that any business needs. We need to be able to get back money in the cash flow and in the bank.
Well, the budget reflects almost a $1.1
million
negative shortfall for next year, right?
Well, we end up
we're
800, 879. 830, yeah,
879.
Revised,
yeah.
It was worse,
page.
Yeah.
There was that one page handout.
It was worse before we did the,
You know, for me to relate to this, though, it's again, it's missing the column that says original, and then the column that says variance.
Right.
And
that's what Leo, you're saying.
I can do that.
Supply you for the sixth.
Well, but for us to even approve this, I mean, if this is an action item, my question is compared to what?
Sure.
And I can't remember the budget. I can't remember as well as Jay does what I say. So I don't know how we can operate with this unless we, if you give us, I mean, even just give me big numbers of what was the original revenue number and what was the original expense number, and I'd be more comfortable. But otherwise, I can't personally deal with this.
I understand. Okay. Original revenue was about 3.5 revenue and expenditures, because it's basically a balanced budget. Now we're looking at almost 2.2.
$3.5 in revenue, and it's now 2.2.
About 2.2.
2.2.
So we're down 1.35.
And 3.5 is a balance, right?
And so the expense.
And the expenses were down 0.5.
Mm-hmm. So. Okay, right at 3 million, or just under. Okay, that makes sense. So we've reduced our expenses by 500,000 projected?
Roughly, yes.
Okay.
Okay, I'm also looking at the cash flow.
Yeah,
is that the problem?
Cash flow, yes.
Okay.
We're gonna look under 13.
But I guess the question is, how much of that reduction is during our operating period, and how much of that is during the non-operating period?
Those,
I mean,
yeah.
And May and June is kind of sad to think that we're going to have an operating loss during the month of June, but...
Well, I imagine it kind of takes us a while to build up after our losses. Well, no, you're right.
Yeah. Part of that, beginning of the season, you've got to stock up on your inventory. You buy your oils, you buy a lot of things that you use all summer long, but they hit the expenses.
How does that compare to this past June? In July, we had a profitable July.
Right. I mean, normally June should make some money rather than lose. Bigger thing is potential reduction in revenue yet in June.
So, how it compares. What is our assumption in ridership here, Leo? I mean, you described that you were unsure what it's going to be and how quick it's going to bounce back. Is this bouncing back to 2009?
No, I think June, we either got it 80 or 85% next year.
Okay.
Saying that it's still going to be slow to get that word out there.
Right.
I mean, May, the fact is you're only going to run
a
4 days as opposed to
right.
a weekend or something
right.
this year, so it's reduced to the actual days.
Mr. Chairman, I mean, in making that comment about June, if June's really going to lose money, I'd rather have the budget reflect it than to have a pie-in-the-sky optimism that we try to take to the bank and end up with nothing to take to the bank. So I respect the fact that this is showing what I guess is a realistic budget. Marvin, do you feel that you can live within this budget?
You better say yes.
No, you don't have to.
Well, as I said, he's one of the guys who helped put the numbers together.
I understand, but I've been in those meetings too, and I had one vote for three or four. So,
oh no, we don't hold a sledgehammer over his head at all.
You know, it's going to be tight. I mean, you know, after we went through all these numbers, everything's going to be tight. We're looking at what we're going to have to buy during that month. It's going to come down to, we don't have, let's say, broken inventories, lost inventory, then I think we'll be okay. Some of these things, we can't anticipate, say they're going to happen or they're not going to happen, so that's the issue with happening.
So it's realistic.
The only
is that what
well,
I mean?
I think
but
you're saying
it's not. It doesn't account for any.
The only other thing I see on this that.